they do?
What do they actually do?
What do they do?
What do they do?
What do they actually do?
The coronation seems a good occasion to discuss why one family live in palaces, all subsidised by us, while folks rely on food banks, and we're supposed to rejoice as a crown is chauffeur brown in a custom-made Rolls Royce. It's time for this to stop. Let's give the royals the chop.
Scrap the monarchy. Scrap the monarchy.
Their pampered lives are gone while people live in poverty. In inhumane conditions, while out-of-date traditions mean we all pay for the royals to live in luxury. So
scrap the monarchy.
King Charles's fingers are so fat, swollen, sore and red from swans that he gets fed and things he does in bed. He propagates the narrative, he's a climate protester, but his best friend was Jimmy Savile, Britain's foremost child molester. And his brother Prince Andrew, he's a nonce case too.
Scrap the monarchy, scrap the monarchy.
They turn a blind eye to their pedos like the BBC. They think that they can pay for it all to go away, but covering up for Nazis is their lasting legacy. So
scrap the monarchy.
What do they do?
What do they actually do?
What do they do?
What do they do?
They sponge off me and you!
But what about Prince William? You're being so unfair. He's never had a mistress or embarked on an affair.
Maybe we have pegged him wrong. He really seems to care.
And there's proof when he does his good deeds, there's always cameras there.
Samaritan's big issue. The list is comprehensive. Not so much Prince Charming, more Prince Charm offensive.
Scrap the monarchy. Scrap the monarchy.
They don't give a hoot about the likes of you and me. Look past their PR and you'll see what they really are. A sinister, callous, entitled ideology. So
scrap the monarchy. Scrap the monarchy.
They stand for racist values and inequality. It's time to have a vote, then stick them all in a small boat and let them take their chances in some far-flung colony.
Scrap the monarchy.